welcome back. If you're coming back, I wanted to do kind of a quick get ready with me with my favorite go-to everyday smokey eye, something I can wear out during the day and obviously have it be a bit dramatic, but a bit more day wear. This is literally step by step the exact way I do it every time. If I ever get stuck. Anyways, I only have about 40 minutes or so because I have to go run and get Oliver from the bus stop. So I feel like I'm rushing a little bit, but and I wanted to give you guys two different lip options so you could do a nude, or I wanted to show you kind of how you can pair a lighter smoky eye with a more bold lip and have it still work together. I already do have my brows on because those take a little while for me, so we're gonna go ahead and jump in. As always, don't mind the music and the baby swing and all that fun stuff. So okay, I'm going to be using my Wet n Wild Photo Focus foundation in the shade light medium buff bisque. I love this foundation. It's $5 and it's awesome. It does come with a little spatula, so you just can kind of paint it on your face. It has a really weird smell, but that's really the only downside to it. It's got a decent coverage, really nice finish. It is slightly too dark for me, so I do, but the other shade that's next to it is too light for me, so I do take it down my neck a little bit, just to make sure that it's blended. And now with this foundation, I do like to use a face brush. So this is the Real Techniques buffing brush. And I just like to kind of spray that down a little bit with some makeup setting spray. And I just go right in. And I, instead of rubbing, I bounce it, kind of pressing the product into my skin. And I do try to work quickly because this foundation does start to dry down a little bit quick, and I notice I can get streaks if I don't work quickly. So I do just kind of buff it in everywhere, the neck, my big fat neck, my ears, down my chin. So after I press it in, I do kind of go in some circular motions just to make sure that I do have it all nice and blended. And you will see in a second, I go over it with my beauty sponge just to, again, make sure that everything is nice and blended. Oh, I forgot I have my brows on. This went right over my brow. I don't usually do my brows first, so it's a little bit of a learning curve today for me. Okay. And then I do just like to take it and just kind of push it into my hairline so we don't have any lines. Please don't mind my hair again. I just pulled it up because I didn't have time to do anything with it. Okay, I think that looks pretty good. Okay, so I'm just gonna take my sponge. There's nothing on it, and I'm just going to lightly bounce it. Just to make sure everything is blended. And I will just kind of drag it down my neck to make sure I've dispersed product and kind of drag it blended out a little bit. So now I'm gonna go in with concealer. Today I'm gonna be using my Maybelline Fit Me in the shade Fair. I really like this. It resembles the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer, but it's drugstore, so that's good. And I am going to put some on my eyelids again. My contact feels very strange. Okay, I'm just gonna bounce this. Pull it down in between my brows. I'm And I like to kind of pinch it a little so it does fit up under my eye better. Oh, this contact is not having it today. This does have a dewy finish, so I do make sure I set this like right away, because if not, it will crease and make my lids and my under eyes, well, not so much my under eyes, but my lids will get oily throughout the day if I don't set it right away. This lighting is weird. We're just gonna work with it. You got the hiccups? So now to set under my eyes and my, just the areas I put my concealer, I'm gonna go ahead and take my Real Techniques sponge, and I'm gonna take my Coty Airspun. I already opened it. This is in the shade Naturally Neutral. This is a really great drugstore powder if you can get over the smell. The smell is like my great grandma's old bathroom smell. It literally smells just like I remember my great grandmother's bathroom smelling. and the smell stays for a while. I've heard they make an unscented version. I haven't found it yet, but if you can do the smell, it's a beautiful powder, and it's, I believe I paid $5 for this at Walmart, and I just made it explode everywhere, even on my shirt. So, if you don't like smells and you know you can't do it, Maybelline makes a really great silica powder. It does flash back, but unless you're gonna be actively taking pictures of yourself with the flash on, you don't need to worry about it. Or, where is it? The powder I used in my last video, the Fit Me Loose powder, is really great too. I know I still have it all over my face. But before I wipe all that away, I am going to be taking my Wet n Wild Photo Focus Pressed Powder. This is in the shade Warm Light. And I'm going to be taking my Eco Tools Domed Bronzer Brush and just lightly setting my face. This foundation I do have to set down, or else I will be super oily because this is a tacky foundation. And now I'm just going to sweep away. Oh, I just put the brush in my eye. That's what it needed. I'm just gonna sweep away that light bake that we did. If this eye waters, I'm sorry, it's not having it today. And I am gonna just take this down the neck because I did put some foundation down there as well. I wanna make sure everything is laying well. I feel like I've got like a spot right here and I don't know what it is. Okay, let's check the time really quick. All right, 30 minutes. We can do it. Okay, so I'm gonna lightly contour my face. Again, I'm gonna be using my Wet n Wild. I didn't mean to be using so many Wet n Wild products. But this is in the shade Dolce de Leche and my Real Techniques contour brush. And I am gonna go a little, like, not crazy, a little darker with my contour and blush and bronzer today, blush and bronzer, because I noticed that after I got everything on, especially in camera, but more so in person too, it kind of, I couldn't really see anything but the highlights, so I am gonna go a little darker than usual, than I usually put on, just to make sure that we can really see it. I always tell like my friends to check your makeup in different lighting before you go out, because I have horrible lighting in my house, and I'll do it in the bathroom, and then I'll leave and I'll get in the car and I'll pull the mirror down and I'm like, oh my god, it looks so bad. So I do like to go, like come out and check in natural sunlight before I leave the house. This way I can make sure that I can fix it if I need to. Okay, I feel like that looks really dark, but I may go back in and add more later after everything else is on, we'll see. So I'm gonna be taking this face powder brush, and I'm gonna be taking my Too Faced, this is the Baked Luminous Glow Bronzer in the shade Sweet Tea. It's really pretty, and I just kind of get it on either side, and I'm just gonna lightly go over that contour just to give me some warmth into my hairline. This does have a slight sheen to the face. It's nothing crazy, adds a slight sheen, but it's really pretty. It's not an intense glitter. So now for blush, I'm gonna be going in with the Milani blush in the shade, if I can open it. This is Luminoso. It's so pretty, it's like a true coral, but it's got a nice glow to it. No glitter, just a really pretty sheen. So I am taking on my Real Techniques stippling brush, and I'm gonna lightly just stipple that onto the face. I'm going with a really natural highlight today. That's why I'm using so many glowy products. This way, you won't miss it when I don't add on a super intense highlight. This is the most beautiful drugstore highlight if you are looking for a natural, everyday kind of glow from within glow. This is the Essence Pure Nude Highlight in Be My Highlight. And it's just, it's stunning. It's stunning, it's stunning. I can't find my other highlighting brush. Here it is. Okay, so I'm gonna be taking my Real Techniques setting brush and just go right into the product. Ugh, it's so pretty. It's so natural looking. I know it probably doesn't with the light hitting my face, but it's so natural looking in person. My husband's calling me. Sorry. It's so natural looking in person that it doesn't lay on the skin. It just kind of sinks in and just, that's so pretty. Sometimes I have to do this with my finger because it is more natural looking. Sorry, I'm just that finger. So pretty, and this is literally, I think, $2.99 or $3.99 at Ulta, and it is bomb. It's so beautiful. Okay, so now we're gonna jump into eyes really quick. I'm gonna be using kind of a mishmash of palettes. Use anything you have that is a similar color. These are really easy colors to find to dupe out, so you don't have to be like, I need that specific palette in order to achieve this look. Really just use whatever you have. I'm gonna be using Makeup Geek shadows today. This is the Makeup Geek and Manny MUA I just threw. but it is the Manny MUA Makeup Geek palette. It is probably my most loved favorite palette of all time. I'm gonna be taking the shade Beaches and Cream, which is a permanent shade. It is the shade right here in the middle, and I'm gonna just lay that all over my lid and my crease, and I'm gonna take it up pretty high. This is pretty much my skin shade, so I don't have to worry about it being too dark for my skin tone. You can also do like any kind of nude shade for your skin tone just to help give you a nice buffer. Now I'm gonna be taking the shade in the middle called Sora. It's just a really pretty warm kind of terracotta shade. And I'm gonna lay that right into the crease. And I'm gonna fluff this out. This is gonna be the shade that I really want to peek through after everything is on. It's gonna give us some really nice warmth. So I'm gonna just fluff this in. I'm not being too precise with this. Like I said, I just want like a nice wash of warmth. And I like these shadows because they're really buildable. You don't get a ton of payoff right away. And with eyeshadows, I find that to be better sometimes. This way it's not just crazy color that you can't blend out if you do put too much on your brush right away. Okay, so now I'm gonna go in with the shade next to it, which is the shade Frappe. And it's just slightly darker, nothing too crazy. And I am gonna be taking this Wet n Wild brush that I didn't clean up very well. But we're just gonna go with it. And I'm just gonna pick up Frappe and I'm gonna put that in the outer V and up into the crease on the outer part. This color doesn't make a huge difference, but it just does give it some nice depth as you add in your colors. And these are very warm tone shadows I'm using. But if you like more cool tones, you can definitely find a more cool tone option. Obviously it won't look the same, but this is a pretty easy standard little skill set you can use with multiple different colors this way. If you want an easy smokey eye, you can just change out the colors and it's got the same effect. This is a Real Techniques eye brush. The name has worn off, so I don't really know, but I'm gonna go back into the shade Beaches and Cream up here and just lightly blend those two together. I don't know why I'm showing you my mirror. Okay, now I'm going to take my Wet n Wild blending brush, and I'm gonna go back in with a mixture of Frappe and this shade down here, which is called Aphrodite. It's this beautiful like chocolate pudding brown color, and I'm going to just kind of stamp this into the outer corner and then blend it up into the crease. So again, Frappe, and then just a tiny bit of Aphrodite and tap it off. And then I'm going to kind of just stamp. And then once I get some color onto my eye, I will start blending. And you can take this as far in as you want. You can go into the inner corner. I usually don't, but sometimes I do. It just depends on how I'm feeling that day. Okay, so now I'm gonna take my big fluffy blending brush again, and I'm gonna go in with Frappe. And I'm just gonna go over that. And now we're going to take, if I can find it, my e.l.f. pencil brush, and we're gonna go into the shade Aphrodite, and I'm just going to stamp this right in the outer corner. See how pretty that is? And then just right out into that outer V. And I'm not really blending right now. I'm just kind of placing this color, and then we're gonna go in with a different brush to blend it all out. So you may think it's a little harsh right now, because it is. This brush is really great to just pack on the color where you want it, or to blend out your lower lashes. So now I'm gonna take my Ulta brush, and I'm gonna mix Frappe and a tiny bit of Aphrodite, and I'm gonna go in and just blend that out. just gonna blend. So I'm just literally going in windshield wipers and then a little bit of circles. Oh, this eye is mad at me today. Okay. So now I'm gonna go back in with this first fluffy blending brush. I almost said bluffy. And I'm gonna go in with that middle shade, Sora, which is that really nice, warm kind of terracotta shade. And I'm going all over all of this just to make sure it's all nice and blended. And then, I'm trying to just make sure that this brown looks the same on both eyes. And blend again. Take a little bit more right here. All right. I think that looks pretty good. So now I'm gonna go in with a flat brush. Yeah, we'll use this one. This is a really, really old Sonia Kashuk brush from Target, but just something flat, something synthetic that can pick up some product. Is what you want. And I'm gonna go ahead and just spray my brush pretty heavily. And I'm gonna go in, this shade is in the palette, but I also have it in a single. It's right here, it's in the shade Luna, yeah. And I have a lot of the Makeup Geek foil shadows because they're so beautiful. So I'll just show you really quick. I have a lot of these, but it's this shade right here, the second shade in. So they do sell it in singles if you want it. I'm pretty sure all of these are sold in singles, so you can also go and pick them up. But I'm gonna just take in this shade with my wet brush and just pick up a decent amount of product, tap off, and then I'm gonna just tap it onto the lid, the outer third of the eye. This is just a really pretty champagne-y shade. It's not really warm, it's not really cool, it's just kind of the perfect mixture. You see? Okay, not blended. Right now we're just trying to put the color on. So my brush, spray my brush again, check the time, okay. We're doing good. And then the eye, we're just gonna pat the color on. Oh, it's so pretty. Okay. I'm gonna go back in with this Wet n Wild brush, and I'm gonna mix Frappe and Aphrodite. Go into this outer corner and just blend those shades together, and then go up into the crease and blend up here too. So again, Frappe, Aphrodite, tap off, and then just tap out those edges, and then drag it in. And tap, so it gets nice and blended. Now I'm gonna go back in with the same brush and just go straight into Aphrodite. And just go over that in the outer area. Just to make sure we're nice and blended. And adding some depth in that outer corner. Okay. Back in with that fluffy blending brush and the shade Sora. Just go over all that. And you will wipe away some of the glitter on the lid. It's okay, it's normal. Okay, so I'm just gonna take this wet brush again, this wet flat definer brush, wet some more if you need to. Pick up a little bit more of Sora, no, Luna. And I'm just going to tap that on again. And then when I get to the outer area, I'm just gonna kind of stipple it so that it blends it in nicely. Tapping, and then I kind of turn the brush and just stipple. And then blend it out with my finger. Okay. Now I'm going to go back in with that pencil brush and I'm going to take Aphrodite and I'm going to go right underneath that lower lash line. And carry that in a little more than halfway. This eye is so hard with this table. My contact is freaking out, man. Okay. And I'm gonna go in and blend that shade, so don't worry. Okay. I'm trying to find what brush I wanna use to buff that out. I had it. I don't know where it went. Oh, come on. The struggle. The struggle, the struggle. Okay. I'm just going in with a brush. This is a Urban Decay brush from a Vice palette. But I'm just going to go in with that shade Sora. Any kind of a pencil looking brush will do. And I'm just gonna go in right underneath that shade and just blend it out. And I am taking this down. You don't have to take it down as far. It's a little further down than I usually do. And then with this other longer side, I am going to just take that shade Beaches and Cream and just go over all that again. And that's going to help kind of lighten up the color a bit. Now that both my eyes are watering like crazy, I think we're pretty much done with that. Go on and blend that a little more. Okay. So I'm going to add some liner, which this part scares me a bit, I'm not going to lie. I'm going to be using the, okay, you got to get going. L'Oreal, this is the super slim liquid liner. It is a felt tip. It's really great. It's nice and precise. And black. Okay, I always have to pull on my eye, which is not good. So I don't really know how I'm supposed to do this because the mirror is so far away, but we're just gonna wait, go for it. We're gonna wing it, no pun intended. Oh wow, this is really hard. Whew. Oh, this is really difficult. Okay, that's good enough. I don't really want a super thick line because the eyes are so pretty. This is what I hate. My mirror is literally like further than an arm's length away, so it's hard to see. So I'm gonna wait a second for that. And I'm gonna take a Q-tip. And I'm just gonna kind of buff that out a little bit. It's not gonna be perfect. And then I'm gonna take the other side, wet it a little bit, or a lot of it, and I'm gonna pick up that Luna shade again. Just on that Q-tip. And I'm gonna try and go over that. There we go. Okay, that fixed it. Try and finish my eye really quick and not mess up again. I feel like I'm almost blind, like I just can't see anything that far. Okay. Looks pretty even. Sorry. I have like everybody calling me right now. Okay. That looks pretty even. Ooh, but my eye's watering, so it's running. We'll fix that. Because my eyes are watering so bad, I'm not going to wing it out because the wing's just going to get messed up. I am going to take this Q-tip and just kind of smudge that corner to help. I hope you guys don't mind this music. This is just what I listen to. This is Pandora. It's the Ready Set Pandora station. I love this type of music. Okay. So we're done with that. So now we're going to go in and highlight our brow bone really quick, our inner corner, and then pop on some mascara and we'll do the lips and we should be done. I'm gonna go back in with my Essence Pure Nude Highlight and just a little pencil brush. This is from Crown Brushes. And I'm just gonna go and do the outer corner and the brow bone. Going to here we go, set my brows really quick with my Ulta Beauty brow gel again in the shade Clear. Okay, so now before we do mascara, I'm going to go ahead and just spray my face, lock everything in, make sure everything's good. Okay. I go crazy with the spray. You don't have to do that much. I just love it. Take my sponge and just lightly dab my face. We have all that on. I'm gonna go in with our mascara. Mascara right here. Again, using the L'Oreal Voluminous Lash Paradise. That is a tongue twister to say. Okay. Oh, I got some on my under eye. I never do, but both times I've gotten it on my face. And I usually never do, so it's kind of crazy. Okay, I have to move this because I can't see with the light. I'm like flicking it onto my face. Being a little aggressive with the mascara. Wow, it's really traveling. See, that's the problem is I have very sensitive eyes and my contacts don't help. So because of that, whenever one eye gets bothered, the other eye gets bothered, and then they just run like faucets. It's great fun. So I'm just gonna kind of run a Q-tip there again just to try and blend that corner. It's not really helping, but that's okay. So here's the finished eyes. You can add falsies. I hate falsies, so I rarely ever put them on. But you can if that's what you want to do. Okay, I think I just turned Pandora off on accident, but it's okay because I have to go. So I'm going to show you two different lip combos. I'm going to show you a red, and then I'm going to show you a nude. Which is probably what I'll wear because I don't want to freak Oliver out with like all this bright makeup on at the bus stop. Okay, this is Flower Beauty's liquid lipstick. It's called Miracle Matte Lip in the shade Crimson Touch. It's beautiful. Actually, you know what? Screw it. I'm gonna wear this one today. So I'm gonna show you the nude first. This is Revolution Makeup in the shade Chauffeur. It's from Ulta. It's like $3. It's really cheap. It's really beautiful. And I just go right in. Revolution Makeup is the brand that usually does like the knockoffs. And then, but they have some good products. Some are not so good, but some are good. And you can top this with a gloss if you want. You can leave it matte. And any nude will do. This is just the kind of nude that I like. See, now I want to leave it on. Ugh, this is my problem. I like nude lips. So I'm just gonna take this off really quick. And then that remover does not taste good. Take a little bit more of my highlighter since I rubbed it off. Put it back on my lips. Now I'm gonna go in with this Flower Beauty lipstick. And I have to go because I have to go put my pants on to go get Oliver. I'm wearing pants, I'm just wearing PJ pants. Don't worry. Okay, I love this lipstick because it's like fluffy mousse, but it dries down really thin, but it doesn't feel, well, it feels thin. It just doesn't look thin. It's got a great consistency. And it's got like a cooling sensation when it goes on the lips. I hate my lips though. They're so uneven. Sorry, I turned off Pandora so I know it's like super quiet. think that looks pretty good. My lips are naturally uneven, so I spend forever trying to get them to look even. It usually doesn't work very well, but this is the lipstick. So you can wear this out. This would probably be like change the lip for like a night look. But if you want to rock a red lip during the day, heaven knows I do sometimes, go ahead and do it. You can make this a little less smoky in the outer corner to make it more daytime appropriate, but this is pretty much the finished look. Again, with two different lip options. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. These are all products that I love, that I use, that I would recommend. So hopefully you found some helpful tips or tricks. I can't speak anymore. But yeah, thank you again for watching. And please let me know if you want to see something specific or change anything. Let me know. I will see you guys later. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.